destiny. And that's why in the book of John chapter 1 said something. He said, without him was not anything. Praise the Lord. I want to ask here with me something here. Please, what is this called? Let's say it together. I thought someone would see a trumpet. Praise God. Can somebody tell me what, from where was this thing made? Hello? A wood. Are we sure? Is it a wood or a metal? A wood, praise God. So now, where do we get wood from? Thank you, man. Somebody say bush, somebody say tree. Somebody say, okay, we get a wood from the bush, from a tree in the bush. So everybody's correct. Or we get a wood from a tree in the forest. But the truth is this, as you look at this wood, I was doing a bit of small research on having of wood. Do you know, if not for technology, it will take at least 3 months to get this shape out. Hello? But is this how a tree is normally? The answer is no. So there is a lot of work done to get these things done. I wish the choir was here so that they would be able to attest what I'm saying. But you know that it is not all wood that can make this guitar. Yes or no?
Yes.
Praise God. We're in the same class now. Thank you. And you know that it is not all wood. There are different parts of this wood. There is this big part and there is this length. They have different materials. In this, they call the strength of materials. So it determines the sound that is produced. Praise God. We'll come back to that briefly. But I want to introduce the lesson. The same a sculptor is an artist who carves or molds a figure. The artist has molded his guitar from this wood. Yes or no? Yes. Designs in wood, stone, clay, or cement. How many of us know this Madoki roundabout? That roundabout before the airport. What is that roundabout?
Horse.
A horse and what? A man on it. Praise God. But you know that thing is from cement. But somebody had to carve those things. Took them time. That is the work of what is called. So we say when a sculptor wants to carve out something, he looks at that thing. All of us can see that thing. All of us have seen it. But when this person that wants to manufacture this guitar looks at that thing, what is he seeing? He's seeing what?
Guitar.
A guitar. Thank God, one of our brothers here is an architect. When you take an architect to a land, you are seeing land. But what is he seeing? A building. So when God looks at you, a man can look at you and see a woman sitting. But when God is looking at you, he's not looking at you as just a woman. God is looking at a prophetess. God is looking at an excellency, a first lady. And that's why he told Jeremiah, I said, before you were born, I formed you. Man, I formed you as a baby. But then I knew you. That means I knew what you would become. I pray God will open our eyes to understand in Jesus' name. He says, he looks at the wood and begins to see what nobody else can see in it. What is the master's sculptor? In today's lesson, we shall be looking at how God can transform us from just a tree or a log of wood into a finished product. Do you know that this guitar, when you go to the market, there are some you see for 15,000, there are some you see for 30,000. And there are some you see for 150. You might say, what is the difference? It might not be in the color, but it might be in the material that was used for it. It might be the amount of work that was done on it. I pray God will help us in Jesus' name. And that's why God was not done with some people, because of the time he took to make them. I pray God will make us this morning in Jesus' name. So someone looked at all the truth. Samuel was looking at the height, looking at the face, but God was looking at what? The heart. Until God saw the heart. God even told Samuel and said, I don't look at the face, I don't look at the body, I don't look at what the person is wearing, I look at what is in his heart. So let us get our hearts right. We will not struggle in life. Let's go to our first lesson of line one. What was the first lesson of line one? Say, let's read it together. Let's read it together. Again. Come to your neighbor and say what? Come to yourself and say what? So what is the raw material? The raw material means in the lower state, it is not yet finished. It is not yet what? Finished. The only time it is finished, it is when you have breathed your last what? Breath. Hello? It is only when you have breathed your what? Your last breath. But as long as you are still breathing, you are in raw material. This guitar here, again, will go back. After it was formed as a guitar, do you know that the moment it ceases to function, to play music, somebody can call it to work again?
Firewood.
Is firewood not useful? It is useful. Do you know, if you take it back to the manufacturer, they can do two things that will serve the whole of Nigeria. You know, two things is very valuable. You'll get plenty to eat. So until you are born in life, you are not yet what? Finished. That's why I want us to establish this moment. Don't give up on yourself and say, I must be tough. Don't give up on yourself and say, I must hold my microphone before I make importance in life. Don't give up on yourself and say, until I have 1 million in my account, I'll be useful. Praise God. Do you know that sometimes when this guitar is not played, the music is empty? Hello?
Hi.
Do you know, if you know music very well, when this guitar is not playing, the music is what? Empty. And you know one thing I like about life and God is this. You are not made for yourself. I'm holding this guitar. Is it aware I'm holding it? I don't think so. But it was created for what? To make others laugh. It was created to make others have joy. And I want to challenge us this morning. You are created. How many people have been made to laugh? How many people have been made to have joy? That is the one material. So let us look at one example. They say, God, the master sculptor, looks for raw materials and mold them to what he wants. God turned Gideon from a coward to a mighty man of valor. You know, Gideon was a very cowardice, a coward. He was an example of coward. He was threshing his wheat. He was hiding. Apart from that, when the angel appeared to him and said, Gideon, thou art the mighty man of God, he said, is it me you are talking to? Then when God said, okay, you are going to lead, he said, show me a proof. God showed him one proof the first time. He said, no, show me another one. And when God said, okay, I'll show you, God was patient with him. He still said, God, I want you to know that you sent me. He still went to the enemy's camp, but when he had a dream, from the enemy that says they saw a dog come in, it was then he was confused. So don't look at yourself and say, when someone said something, that Bible does not lie. The Bible does not paint pictures of people and make them look like heroes. The Bible shows us their what? Their weaknesses. Why? Because it wants us to know that they are human beings like what? Us. It is nowadays pastors want to show you as if it's a superstar. But the Bible is complete. The Bible shows another person that was a raw material was what? Was David. We read about David in the text. We said when they called the 8 children, the father would not even call him among them. He was tending sheep. Even when he went to meet his brother at the long front, they said, you, what are you doing? This will be the next word. In fact, we will be the one that will deliver the country. You can imagine the whole of Nigeria. One small boy. Probably 17 years. And then when Saul said, take my armor. Where is the proof? Where is the helmet? David said, I've not tested these things. Give me my stone and my what? Sling. Catapult. And funny enough, when Goliath saw him, Goliath said, you think we are here to work, to play. And we all know how the story ended. I don't know how rich your family were. But we knew about that they were said something. He said, when the first bishop came to their hometown, he said all of them were lined up to go and greet the person, one class, anybody. And then he said in his mind that one day somebody, people will welcome him like this. Yes or no? Is it happening? Hello? Is it happening?
Yes.
It has happened. And it can happen to you. We're not talking about fame, but we're talking about fulfilling your purpose in life. Hello? We're talking about, it might not be, all of us might not be very famous, but all of us can fulfill our purpose. I pray God will help us in Jesus' name. Another person that was around material was Moses. They said Moses was a runaway, a fugitive. But then God changed him. He ran away. But then after a time, God gave him, turned him around and made him a leader. You know, Moses was so terrified. He did not even have confidence about himself. He said, I am a stammerer. I cannot what? Talk. Funny enough, do we think Moses was really a stammerer in life? I don't think so. It was because of what? Fear. In the book of Acts, the Bible says Moses was a great orator. For him to be a prince in Egypt is not my mind, but because of his past experience, he felt, I cannot do it. And then God changed him. What am I drawing up from here? Sometimes some situations might take away our courage. Some situations might take away our boldness. We might have failed not because we had all the things we need to do. Not because we had all the talent. And you might want to take away our courage, but do not be distressed. You can bounce back like Moses. You might have some dreams before when you were small. You said, before now, this and this only I said they will not come. You felt it. Life is like this. But then, if you remember the story of Moses, you know that God can turn your raw material into a finished good. God molded Peter, a fisherman, to become a what? A fisher of what? Of men. In short, you know Jesus even disgraced Peter in his own profession. He said, perform all night. You know, if you like fish, is rest. So it's easier to catch them. But we cannot catch. Jesus lost stone to your right. And Peter, when he saw the fish, he caught, he was ashamed. So all my years, all we just need to do, just like this Peter, is to keep our hands, our life in the hands of the Lord. I pray God will help us in Jesus' name. He said, God is waiting and looking for you to come look to something great in the future. I like that word. He said, God is waiting and looking for you. The problem is not God. The problem is who? Us. Hello? The problem is not God. The problem is what? Us. Why? Because sometimes when God starts with us, we run away. We don't want to stay finished. He said, God will make up the difference between what you are and what He wants you to be. Affect you. Class activity 1. Measure the difference between what you were in the last 10 years and what you are at present. Can you think back in the last 10 years? What were you doing? And what are you doing? Any improvement? If there's improvement, let me show you. If there's no improvement, let me see your letter. Praise God. Okay, let me tell you one. Last 10 years, I was addicted to pornography. Very, very well. When I mean very well, very, very well. I was addicted to masturbation. But now, it's over. The truth is this. All you need is to want to submit. God can use anything. Can use anybody, anything, and any time. I pray God will help us in Jesus. That this word comes to our heart. We might not have much time, but let it sink I saw Abuye during the week online. I saw him in the private jet. And somebody said, Baba has arrived. Bishop Abuye for me. But you know that sometimes, let me say 1995, I listened to a tape that I said, when you married, he did not have a chair in his house. He had only a bench. I'm not saying chair, bench in the parlor. And there was no fridge. When the wife, him and the wife were drinking water, but so we drink this cold water in the plate. But look at where it is. So if God can change somebody's story, God can change your own story. God can transform you. God can make you fulfill what you ought to be in life. So let's look at the processing state of this molding. We said to transform a piece of wood to a finished molding. Passes us through the following stage. This is our finished product, yes or no? Yes. But now, when God sees this wood, he fetches the wood from the bush by cutting the tree and carries it home. We all agree that this was from a tree, yes, I mean. But now, is it the tree? No. The tree was taken, it was first cut. And taking them. And what does that imply? It is the salvation process. All of us were formerly in the forest as raw wood. Do we agree? All of us were human beings. There are billions of us on this earth. But then God will have to cut you out from others. That cutting out might look painful. Why? Because a tree, when it is cut, becomes what? Dead. Drop us. True. You have to cut the life that you are enjoying. And that is the salvation process. God has to cut some of us. And that's why some of us are sitting here. We are not in the beer barrel. We are not in the club. We are not at home watching African match or zero. Why? Because God has cut us from it. But you know the problem? Some of us who are satisfied with only the first stage, was accepted with any salvation, we do not want to go further. Then the second stage peels off the back of the wood. Then you have the white wood. That is the peeling means taking off unwanted parts from us. Praise God. Taking off the unwanted parts from us so that the white parts of us can come out. And what is that unwanted part? When we are saved, there are some nature that still remains in us. God begins to what? Cut them off. To prune them. Example of some of those things that we used to do are what? Example of the peeling off. Habits. Can somebody tell me that? Anger. Praise God. Do you know Moses had anger? At different instances, you see, you say, Moses was angry. He left the presence of Pharaoh. Then we say, don't worry, I will use this anger later. And 40 years later, he used it against him. He might not have done the same. So why not we let God peel off that unwanted part? So of course, you say, see, I can take anything more, but this anger, me, I don't use to joke with it. If I'm angry, I'm angry. It should not be something to be proud of. Let the sculptor peel it off. Yes, another thing. Pride. You know some of us, those days when you want to see a proud man, you see him with his shoulder, you see him bent. But you know that sometimes pride is in the heart. It is so disguised nowadays that people will not see it. But you, the carrier, will know. Hello? You, the carrier, will know. You need that. Ha! God bless you. And as best as prayer for them, be yourself. Your teacher is teaching his own teacher. What is it for? What does he do in himself? He's all talking. He's in the heart. I pray God will help us in Jesus' name. Another thing that peeling up, that can be peeled up, yes. You said anger, pride, yes. Praise God. They say, will you be at home? You say, let me see. You know you'll be at home. So what is let me see? Praise God. What is let me see? You somebody was called, you know what to be this called. You let him know. But instead of you to say, sorry, I didn't want to be your call. You say, I saw on this call. Did you not see me call? Why did you? Or why did you say I didn't want to speak? But you made it as if it was me's call. You were doing other things. All are small. They say small lies, blue lies, white lies. All liars shall go to work. Number three, this doctor uses hammer, Jesus. That's what we saw here. This thing was that. If you come here and you see that this place is bent, there was a chisel. And that chisel is the role of the word of God. It is chopping off other unnecessary parts. Some of us, we are born again. We want to grow. But when the word of God comes strong to us, we say, this one, I cannot take it. Let me give us an example. A rich man approaches to say, what must I do to inherit the kingdom of God? God said, you must be born again. Give father and say, yes, I've done that. Then he said, sell all you have and follow me. At that point, he said, the rich man, come. Why? The word of God came to you, but it's not all the words he said. If we really want to become the product God wants us to be, we have to let the word of God have its way in our lives. Some of us, after we talk, we're not here. Even when they quote scripture, we still know what? We're not here. Same thing, my own is, pray, let's say, let's go home. God will help us in Jesus' name. They say the smooth stage is the smoothing of the rough edges. And paper to make it smooth. If you touch it, very smooth. Whereas, if you see a rough thing, you cannot do that. To make it to specification, then the fifth stage is the polishing, shining, cleaning, and that is the role of what? The anointing through the Holy Spirit. So why do we admire some great men of God? It is because they put themselves under these five processes. Which we can be there. We can get there. We can fulfill purpose. We can fulfill destiny. I've already said it. We are not born to live for ourselves. Everything we are in this life is for everybody. For the world to benefit. So take it. If this is the only thing you can remember today, just know that you are living for everybody, not for yourself. And until you discover that purpose, my brother, my sister, you might be wasting life. You might be wasting life. So let us submit to God, the master talking. As somebody says, God is not true with you yet. You are still working what? Progress. Say that to yourself. God is not true with me yet. I am still working progress. You see, in summary, stop struggling with your maker. Yield yourself at that love of God. Stop struggling. Every situation, Romans said that all things work together for good. Together what? That love God. Everything you are passing through, what looks like pain, is shaping to you. What looks like a stretch is increasing your spiritual muscle so that you can have capacity. When David was going elsewhere, he did not know that God was doing it for a purpose. God humbled him to the extent that when Micah was mocking him. He said, I was nobody when God took me to the throne. He understood. This morning, he read about Joseph and Daniel. Joseph, God made him to pass through people that intentionally hurt him so that he can easily forgive his brother. His brothers mocked him. Potiphar's wife lied against him and mocked him. But then when he ascended the throne, it was a bit easy for him to forgive. God made him to say no to things. He experienced all kinds of things. So what you think is your wilderness experience might be that you are a factory that God is making you. I pray God will open our eyes of understanding. You might not get that job now, but the experiences you are having is for you to be able to tell somebody that did not have a job, that don't worry, this job will come. When we lost our son, I felt very bad. But then I could not see that. I could tell somebody that, see, don't worry, God will be there. So everything that we're passing through is in the making. The making. Until you are made and fully made, then you cannot see God using it. Let us not be stubborn. I pray God will help us in Jesus' name. Any question? Contribution? Yes, ma'am. Question? So we count the question. I don't want questions that will bring questions. Okay, one question, yes, two. So I'll just take only two. Okay, ma'am.
Praise the Lord. My question is that of Paul. If someone calls and talks, your phone is ringing, and you know that this call might be something of God, and you don't know it's not the call. So later, maybe you reply the call, or you see the person face to face, and you tell the person, I saw your missed call. So how is it seen when I'm trying to avoid things that I'm not going to reply?
Praise God. Okay, can somebody address that? That's under the line, you mentioned the line. I would say that there are some technical lines that people do. Let me give you another technical line. It's like an alibi, we call it alibi. I can park my car in front of church, right? Hello? I park my car in front of church, then I'll enter Jesus to go and drink beer. But you know, everybody that comes here for my is inside church. Yes or no? Okay, three parts.
Reason. Absolutely speaking, you were having to authority. And that's a people call. And as well, people call up that person, sorry, I'm not coming, sorry, I'm not doing this, I'm not doing this, and the client is request or her request. And we decided to allow the phone to finish with you. I want to tell you that I saw your list call. Yes, I agree with what Aficha said, that is a lie. Because before you saw the list call, you have seen me calling, you have seen my calling. It is not proper, because people in ministry background when you say, okay, the last one, no. It is not proper to say, I saw you calling, I intentionally decided not to be. Let's not pick up again and call you, no. Praise God. So it is a lie. It is a lie because that was not the main thing. You have decided not to pick. So you are trying to use excuses to cover up. Justify your ammo while you need to get the call. Thank you.
Okay, did you have one sense? Okay, what class are you?
Sir, tell me the person I don't know who to pick your call. Who the person know the ammo?
Hello. Praise God. In today's workout meeting, we said something. We said righteousness or holiness. Hello. One house. Righteousness or holiness has a price. It has a cost. Hello? And also, at the end of the cost, when you have paid that cost, there is a price. That's a gift. Hello? It's not the same way. We talked about policemen. You say, Oga, I am not going to collect 50 naira at checkpoint. Would your life be happy? Hello? Will you say, take handshake? You will not. In fact, they will post you to Fufure. Praise God. There is a cost and there is a price at the end of everything. What we are not saying is this. When you lie, you know. Hello? When you are lying, what did I say? You know. It's the truth. God might declare. People might not know. the devil and you will know. Something will tell you that this thing you are saying is not what true. Our daddy was talking about accounting this morning. You know that in accounting there is a part they call creative accounting. You create something to block it. But even them, they know that it's honest. Praise God. Everyone decided. The truth is, when we fall down, we should what? We should rise. We are not saying we are perfect. That's what we still said here about this guitar. Do you know that you might look at it and clap, but there are some people in the company that will tell you that the thing is still not as what they want it to be. They call them control. They call them quality assurance. And that's why sometimes they go, they don't have to revoke some of the cars and sent out because of the emission problem. But we, what do we know? We try the car pan down. But the manufacturer knew that something was still working. No. Any other question before I pray? Contribution. Okay, let's bow our heads to pray. Let's ask that God grant me the patience for transformation. Help me to be patient. Help me to be submissive. Some of us, we want to be great. We want to be used by God. But we are not submissive. Some of us, we are not patient. We grumble, we cry, we weep. While we are passing through our trials, we are submissive. We compare ourselves with others, forgetting that everybody has a shape God wants him to be. From this example, from a wood, a guitar can come out, a toothpick can come out. The main thing that will fulfill your purpose. Let's ask that God, help me to become what you want me to be. Help me to become what you want to be. In Jesus' name.